friends, and welcome to All the Things TV, where we tackle full living and goal getting with the grace and gifts God gives. I'm Tiffany Jo Baker, and today I'm super excited to introduce you one of my newer friends, but in a similar space, Krista. Krista Hutchins, thanks so much for being here with me.
Thank you so much for inviting me. This is really fun.
I'm so super excited. We got connected through, I think, mutual people and, you know, the great platform of Instagram. And I know you've had me on your platform doing an Instagram live. So I'm just so excited. There's so much in you. And I think we just connect on a lot of levels.
Yeah.
So yeah. I think my people and your people are really going to enjoy the conversation we have.
I hope today. So.
They will. Well, friends, let me tell you a little bit more about Krista. So Krista Hutchins uses tough grace to equip busy communicators and leaders with project management and problem solving skills so they can turn their big ideas into a successful ministry business. And we love that. She's passionate about teaching women to find practical application of the Bible in their personal, professional, and ministry lives. Her and her hubby live in South Louisiana in a delightfully empty nest. Let's just pause there. That sounds fabulous.
It has its days for sure.
I'm sure it does. And we know we all love our children. So nobody
get that. Both of my children.
Nobody get that twisted. But well, today, Krista, I know you are big on, one of the things we talk about here is successful relationships. Mm-hmm. And we know that God has not put any of us in a bubble, even though during COVID, we feel like we're in a bubble. But it takes people and support and community to do what God's called us to do. So I want to unpack with you, because you have so much to say on this topic, on when you have this goal, we talk about full living and goal getting, you have this goal and it needs to happen, but you can't do it all on yourself. And it takes accountability. We need people in our life to help us do what we've been called to do. So how can accountability help us reach our goals?
Yeah, because, you know, we're really pretty good, especially our really goal-getting girls. We're really good at having a good vision, having, know where we're headed, having a plan to get there. But the thing that sometimes we leave out is the accountability. And accountability is what gives us the day-to-day motivation to get up and do the thing, whatever the thing is for that day. So just knowing that someone is going to check in with you or that you have to report into someone. I've had so many people tell me, oh, I just did this morning because I knew you were going to check in on me this afternoon. Mm-hmm. And so just having that person to check in on you and know that you are doing the things that you've committed to do really can make all the difference. I feel like it's the great missing piece for so many people who make all these great plans, but then, 2 weeks later, 3 weeks later, they've not done anything that they plan to do.
Oh, 100%. So I knew that I was supposed to write a book this year. Mm-hmm. And so I invested in an accountability program for writers, basically, because I knew that if I put money into it, if people were going to hold my feet to the fire, that I'd be more likely, I'm checking in monthly, I'd be more likely to do it. And so far it's worked. So I agree 100%.
Yeah. I've been doing a lot of accountability coaching for writers lately, either, mm-hmm. Trying to get their proposal done before a big conference or doing their, getting their manuscript done after there's been some interest. And so, that's a place I really love to work with people because you already have kind of those natural planning and structure bents, but a lot of really creative people, writers, they've got these big, wild, audacious dreams, mm-hmm. and these beautiful words that they can string together and touch our hearts, but they struggle with the organization and the accountability and what's my step today, what's my step tomorrow, and getting those things done. So I feel like that's an area where I just love to see people making progress, not just for the sake of making progress and checking things off, mm-hmm. but because they're actually seeing the things they've dreamed about mm-hmm. come true because they're able to stay on track to the things they've committed to do.
So true. So what makes a good accountability partner?
Well, there's a couple of things, and it depends on what you need. Now, some people, when they are talking about accountability partners, that what they really want is just a cheerleader. Mm-hmm. They want somebody who will just come in and say, "You're doing great. You're doing awesome. You're just, you know, it's okay if you didn't do that. Just keep going." And that's great. That's good. That can be what you need if that's the type of person you need. At the other end, some people want a drill sergeant. They want somebody who's going to come in and put the hammer on them and make them feel horrible if they don't do what they did, what they were supposed to do, remind them of all the reasons they were supposed to do it. But I find for most people, what you really need is somewhere in between. And that's what I call the tough grace. That is the grace that knows that life is going to happen. You're going to miss some of your check boxes. But they love you and care about you and your dream too much to let you use that as excuses to continue not doing what you're supposed to do. And so with some tough grace, you get some understanding mm-hmm. and some flexibility, but you also get that person saying, "All right, we didn't, you know, you didn't get it done this week. What were the barriers that kept you from getting it done? And so how are you going to remove those barriers next week?" It's a little bit more than just saying, "Rah, rah, you can do it again," or making you feel horrible because you didn't get it done, but really getting in and helping you figure out, how do you get it done? How do you make progress? And then holding you accountable to do those things.
That's so good. I love it. Tough grace. You know, because so many of us get in the weeds mm-hmm. and we get stuck on the little things or perfectionism or overwhelm. So having an outsider perspective to be able to see through, see what really matters.
Yeah.
Because so many times we get stuck on the things that don't right. matter a lick.
Right.
So having that outside perspective is so, so good.
Yeah.
So, Krista, what would you say, how does somebody find a good accountability partner?
So you can look in, there's several different places you can look. Of course, look among your friends who might be willing to walk along beside you, but you have to be careful there because they're more likely to be cheerleaders mm-hmm. and not want to disrupt their relationship with you and their friendship with you. But if you have a friend who knows enough to just help keep you going, a friend can be a great place. Look in your Facebook groups. If for whatever thing it is you mm-hmm. do, you're probably in a Facebook group mm-hmm. that has to do with that. So there'll be people in there who are trying to accomplish some of the same things. So find people in there with common goals. Sometimes it's best to look for a mentor type person who's been there, done that, that mm-hmm. you can follow along behind there, and they can give you tips to get unstuck and how to keep going. And then of course there's lots of paid programs. I know you mentioned you're mm-hmm. in a writer's accountability group. I have an accountability mastermind mm-hmm. and coaching. And so there's lots of coaching type programs and people who can provide that accountability for you for not as much cost as you might think.
That's so, so true. And it's so worth the investment because there's so much time wasted, right? When we're not doing the thing that is on our house to do, and then we can feel bad about not doing it and then look back. So it really is worth an investment of your time and your resources to get in groups, to find accountability people, to invest in a coach or a mentor or a mastermind group of some time to move the ball forward. And I think, isn't your book called Moving Forward? Is that right?
Yes, my book is called Moving Forward, Inspiration for the Go-Getter Jesus Girl.
Oh, love it. Love, love, love it. Well, one of your favorite verses I know is Matthew 11:28-29. Says, "Are you tired, worn out, burned out on religion? Come to me, get away with me, and you'll recover your life. I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me and work with me. Watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you." Why does that speak to you?
Well, I think, you know, the first part that drew me and that, you know, kind of gets a lot of attention about that message translation about the that verse is the part where it says unforced rhythms of grace, which I think we all need that. In my life, so many things feel forced. And like I have to spend time on at work. I have to, you know, take care of my family. I have to. Mm-hmm. So much of things feel forced. And I love that I can just come before Jesus and find his unforced rhythms and mm-hmm. just kind of go with his flow. But I think the part that's really speaking to me a lot lately, and especially kind of around the idea of accountability, is the part where he says, watch with me and work with me, and I will teach you how to have a real rest. Mm-hmm. And so especially for us go-getter types, when we like rest, I don't want to rest. I don't want to sit and rest. Jesus says, he doesn't say, come and sit in the fields with me and lay and watch the clouds and I'll show you how to rest. He says, come walk with me and work with me mm-hmm. and I'll teach you how to rest. So he, you know, he's not, it's not all about just rest. Is not all about just laying and physically resting. For some of us, I'm at rest most when I am working on some of my goal type stuff. Mm-hmm. That's when I feel fulfilled and when I'm resting. And so walking with Jesus, working with him and achieving rest at the same time is just something that really is speaking to me right now.
I love that. I get the picture of the three-stranded cord, like in an mm-hmm. accountability situation. It's Jesus, right. us, and our accountability partner. And yeah. we each play a role and we each move the ball, help to move the ball, God's dream, God's goal for our lives forward.
Right.
Well, Krista, thank you so, so much for being here today. Oh, we could talk about this probably for a long time because there's so many benefits and so many facets, but I think you did an amazing overview. I so appreciate having you here and your time.
Thank you so much. It's been great to be with you.
Thank you. Well, friends, that's another episode of All the Things TV. I'm Tiffany Jo Baker, helping you fuel and fulfill your faith journey through the ups and the downs with small wins, simple strategies, and successful relationships. Now go do all the things that God's called you to do with the grace and the gifts he's given you.